we are going to see how to customize a Google Meet using the institutional email ID supplied to us. In this process, it involves three steps. Step number one, we have to create a Google form. For this purpose, that Google form shall be shared to the students through WhatsApp. The purpose of this Google form is to collect the Google email address which is required to schedule the Google Meet meeting. Step number two, collection of email addresses from the students using that Google form that we have created. Step number three, scheduling of Google Meet class. So these are the three steps involved in this. Let us see these three steps one by one. First, creation of Google form. For each class, there is a separate official institutional email ID has been already given. I have taken the email ID for 3rd BSc Chemistry A section students. So 3rd BSc Chemistry A class email ID that I have taken for demonstration, I have logged in using that email. Now in the same email ID, I am going to create an Google form to collect the email address of the students. For that, let me click on the toggle points shown here. Press over it. Look for forms. Here there is the option for forms. Click over it. A new tab is opening where you can find the different types of forms. You know, you can find the options for different types of forms. You just select blank. Then edit all these options to get a form. Here you can put, I am going to create a form for 2019 3rd BSc Chemistry A section students, student details. And if you want, you can fill the form description. Please supply only Gmail address. And you can ask questions. What are the details required that can be, you know, added as a question. Let me show you one such pre-created Google form here. So this is the form for 2019 3rd Chemistry A section. It is the form to submit the email ID for registering the online class in Google Meet. Only Gmail address will be accepted. What are the field that we are going to collect? Name. So an example is given. So the student has to enter their name here. Then register number. The student has to enter their register number. Register number. Then email. Make this email as mandatory so that there is a star over there. Only Gmail will be accepted. Then phone number, right? Make all these columns mandatory, right? Register number, email ID, phone number, all these columns are mandatory. Of course, the name, name also mandatory field. Fine. Now, see this phone number, we have given the disclaimer that, right, phone number for what purpose we are using. Fine. So we are collecting phone numbers. Why? So if we want to follow the student for any kind of performance assessments like summation of assignments, quiz, class notes, etc., etc., we can use this working phone number. Fine. So these are the data that we are going to collect from the students. Okay. Once after the creation of this form, right, press the settings button. Here there are three options: general, presentation and quiz. Go to general. Here you just requires sign-in, limit to one response, so that a student cannot submit the data more than once. Then respondents can edit after submit. After submission, if the students are looking their answers, if they found that they have made any mistakes consciously or unconsciously, they should have the options to edit it. So that press this checkbox ticked, edit after submission, and then in the presentation side and quiz side, do nothing, press save. Then go to second option. There you can find three options again. Send via email. Here you can get link. There is another options, embedded HTML. Go to link. Then there is a checkbox named sort and URL. Click over it. You will get a small link, very small length link. Press copy. We are ready with this form. If you want to preview this form before getting the link, you can press over this icon. Preview option will be shown there. You can press it, then you can find the preview. So that here it will be looking like this. What are the data we are asking? That will be appearing. So this is the similar template that will be appearing to the students when they are once they are clicking over the link that is we are going to share with the students. Fine, we have taken the links. Go to the WhatsApp group that you are having for your class. So 2019, I am going to my class group. I'm just pasting it. Wait for a few seconds. If you are waiting for a few seconds, then here it will come. 2019 third chemistry year, the title, the first, this first slide will be appearing here as a preview. It is a form to submit the email ID for registering the online class in Google Meet. Only Gmail address will be accepted. You just press to send the students. So in this way, we can do it. So we have shared this link to the students using WhatsApp. So once this link is shared, the students are started to submit their responses. The responses will be collected in the responses option. Okay, the same Google form. First option is questions and second option is responses. In this response, you have to download the responses as an Excel sheet. Here you can find view responses in sheet, click over it. Then an Excel sheet will be opening. You have to download this Excel sheet. Go to file, then download, then press Microsoft Excel. A file will be automatically downloaded. In that way, I have downloaded a file for third chemistry A section students. So I am having the file, right? Here, this data's generally, this data will be on, you know, it will be stacked like this. It will be stacked ascending order in terms of timestamp. In terms of timestamp, it will be stacked so that originally it will be look like this. Originally, it will be looking like this. The numbers, register numbers will be randomly stacked, but if you want to stack the students list in terms of register number, you select the register number column, then sort A to Z, expand selection, you will get the data which is stacked in terms of register numbers. By checking the register numbers, you can find which are the students have not submitted their data. Okay, you can carefully look for the errors in the email ID, if any. Sometimes the students may mention the first letters capital. Generally, email ID will be taken as small letters. Similarly, check for the 10-digit phone numbers. Sometimes student may be submitting some other number, or they might have commit some mistakes. So in this document, we are having name, register number, email ID, phone number. But to create a Google Meet, to schedule a Google Meet, we are requiring the email IDs of the students. That's it. That is what we are having in the D column. Okay. Fine. Now we have collected the email address of the students. Come back. Go to the email ID, the class email ID, that is 3rdBSCChemistryA@gdnartscollege.ac.in. Now we have to schedule meeting. For scheduling the meeting, click over the calendar icon. That is, you know, stacked here. Calendar icon is located just below the symbol Google, right? So here there is a right top calendar. Click over it. Here the calendar will be opening. Wait for a few seconds. If we are using first, then it will look like this. Do one thing, there is an arrow mark. Press over it. This calendar will be opening in a opening. Right? In this, we have to create a Google Meet schedule. For that, press create. Then here you can put a title. This class, third year, 2019 batch, third year, Chemistry A. And this meeting is scheduled from Monday, August 30. We can start from today, September 2. Okay, September 2. O'clock, for example, and then it is does not repeat, and find another time. We have to add the end date. Press video conferencing, Google Meet video conferencing. We have included start date, and it, you press all day, then you can give the end date, December 31, and then after that, right? If you press all day, you can find the end date. Then you close the checkbox, then you can find the end time of the meeting. That is, you can put 5 p.m. Okay, so the meeting will be starting from Thursday, September 2 to 9 o'clock to 31st December, Friday, 5 p.m. And you press, you ensure that it is does not repeat. Right, you have created the link for that. Then you can press save. Before that, check the settings. So quick access, the host must join first. Only the people invited by the host can join without asking. Everyone else must ask to join. People can't join anonymously. Only host can dial out for a meeting. It implies that the faculty has the control, right, over the meeting. The host must join first. The faculty must join first. The email IDs added in this meeting only will be joined to this meeting. Anonymous students cannot join. The students who are having link alone cannot join. Email IDs must be already registered to participate in this meeting. That is called schedule meeting. You press save. Okay. Then we can press save button here. You can press save button here. Once after doing that, you can find in blue bar. A blue bar, you just allow everything. A blue bar which will be running, from 2nd September 2. You can move on point anywhere. October, the same meeting continues. It will be continuing till the December 31st. That is what we have scheduled. Okay, for the first January, it won't appear. Okay, right. Now we have scheduled a meeting. but we haven't added the email IDs of the students. For that, double click over it. Right now, this side here, you can uncheck all this guest permissions, modify event, invite others, see guest. Guests don't have any permissions. All the privileges should be given only to the host, that is faculty. So that here you can put modify event so that no guest can be access this. Fine. Now add guest. For the guest, we have to add the email IDs of the students. Just copy all the email IDs. I have 30. Number one, title. So from 2 to 38, there are 37 email IDs I have copied. Just put the cursor here and press Ctrl V. Then press Enter. Right? All 37 guests were added here. Okay, all 37 guests were added here. Fine. Now, I need to, now you can save here. And would you like to send the invitation emails to the Google Calendar guest? If you press send an email, email will be sent to all the participants of this Google Meet. That is, the email will be sent to all the students. But as we are doing it as an, you know, it's a test scheduling, so I'm not doing anything. Just press, I'm pressing don't send. Right? And then you can invite all guests. Press invite all guests. That's it. It is saved. Now, Google Meet is scheduled. I have to check it whether it is scheduled or not. For that, again go here, press over this apps, open Meet. Right? See, here you can find the email ID, third BSc Chemistry. A meeting is scheduled 9:30 a.m. to come. It is a continuous meeting. It is scheduled 9 a.m. 2019. Now you just press. Initially, it will ask some permission. You press allow. Then this will be getting ready. It will be asking you to join. You just press join now. In the first time, go to host controls, there click over here, view all host settings. Here you just press host management, lets you restrict what participants can do in the meeting. First thing, let everyone share their screen. That is not required, so you can turn off. Send chat messages. Right? When it is turned off, only host can send the chat messages. Okay, let it be, the messages may be enabled. If you have the confidence that you can have the control over the messages, you can leave it enabled. If you assume that you cannot control the messages, the students shouldn't chat themselves. In that cases, you can check out these two cases, right? Instead, you can check out this. Okay. Just do that. You can do one thing. Let everyone share their screen. You turn off. Send the chat messages. If you want, you can enable. Otherwise, you can turn off. Suppose if you are turning off the host management as a whole here. What happens? Turning off the host management, let's say everyone admit and remove others. That should not be. Mute each other. The student can mute themselves. That should not be. The student can record calls. That should not be. Control their own mic and camera. So all these present to all, present the call, these all should not be done by the student. So turn it off only if sure everyone in the call will act responsibly. No. So cancel this, you enable this. Host management should be under the control of the teacher. So that this first one is should be enabled, second and third should be disabled, and fourth should be enabled. So this settings you can make first. That's it. Now your meeting is ready. As like what is appearing to you in the Google account of the classroom, as here this is scheduled for all students who has registered, for all students when they open Google Meet, this schedule will be appearing. The students can press once and they can keep on in the meeting till the end of the class, that is at 1:30. Okay, now we have added the students, right? Here we have added the students, and if you want to add the faculties, for example, if you want to add my name, let me do it. Jyoti Murugan Physics at GTN Arts College .ac.in. Press enter. Okay. Now let me check whether this meeting is appearing for me. Would you like to send invitation? Let me press don't send. But you can press send, right? If you are originally scheduling a meeting, you can press send. I am scheduling this meeting for demo so that I don't send anything. Now let me open my email ID. Where is my email ID? Third chemistry, this one. Okay. Let me open another email ID. Jyoti Murugan Physics at GTN Arts College. Press got it. In the Google Meet and Google Calendar itself, allow, press allow, cancel. Wait for the changes. In the Google Calendar itself, the remainder is shown. Let me open the Google Meet using my email account. Let me check whether this scheduled meeting appears for me. If it appears for me, it will appear for the students as well. You can see that. Jyoti Murugan Physics at gtnartscollege.ac.in. Here also it appears. We have scheduled this meeting in the 3rd BSc Chemistry A. And it is appearing for me now. I can press join now. So press join. Fine. So I have joined now. Now the point is, we have to add all the faculty's email ID who are handling this class. Also, we have to add all the students' email ID. For that purpose, we have created the Google Forms to collect the email ID from the students. Also, we have added the email IDs of the higher authorities who are going to monitor your class, like principal, vice principal, academic director, etc., etc., deans, whoever it may be assigned to monitor your class. And their email ID should be added in this meeting so that they can enter into this class anonymously at any time, and they can leave the class anonymously at any time. So this is the outline of creating or customizing or configuring a Google Meet using our institutional email ID. If there are any other clues or points or shortcuts which we need to supply to the faculties, that we will be supplying that information through principal. And before winding up, let me tell you, you can click over the scheduled link and you can add the email address n number of times. If you want to delete you can choose any email ID, you just press delete. For example, I have added my name. So if I want to delete, locate my name, here is my name, you just press, it will be automatically removed. Then see, whatever the changes you are making, don't forget to save, okay? So this is the basic information. So apart from that, there are other sophisticated facilities that is available in Google Meet, Google Calendar, that you can explore yourself, you can get to learn. Thank you very much. Once if you have added all the email IDs of the students and faculty, then the faculty need not press admit to the students when they are joining into the class. Also, students will be always remain in the classroom, I mean this meeting, from 10 a.m. to 1:30, except during the break time. The faculty can enter during the time specified to them and they can take the class and they can leave the meeting, while student will be always staying in the meeting. That is the idea. This parent ID, that is that BSc Chemistry A at gtnartscollege.ac.in, that will be under the control of head of the department, while the individual faculties are added with their institutional mail ID and they can join into this meeting during their respective period. They can take class and they can leave the class at the end, and so that no student will be admitted manually. The student can join automatically, they also can leave automatically, okay? And as the students' names are now renamed as register number and name, so if you take the screenshot using your mobile, automatically in an ascending order you can get the attendance screenshots. One thing, shortly we will share a short video about how to take attendance in Excel sheet. Thank you.